हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ मनोज पाटिल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, MUPS KBTE सिविल, नासे। सी स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डिसइंफेक्शन। ओके, दैट इज डिसइंफेक्शन ऑफ द वाटर। सी, इन दिस वीडियो आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द डिसइंफेक्शन, ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द डिसइंफेक्शन, देन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डिसइंफेक्टन which we have to be utilized for the disinfection purpose, then mechanism of the disinfection, then the methods of the disinfection, and lastly factors affecting disinfection process. Okay, see, let us start. Disinfection: water after passing through the aeration, coagulation, flocculation, sedimentation and filtration tank contain small percentage of pathogenic microorganisms, and these processes of the water treatment like coagulation, sediment aeration, coagulation, flocculation, sedimentation, filtration remove only few types of bacteria. Therefore, it is necessary to destroy almost all these disease causing bacteria. Okay, therefore disinfection is a process of killing all the pathogens. Okay, therefore the process of killing all these pathogenic bacteria from the water, that process is known as disinfection. See, sterilization, again there is different term, that sterilization, disinfection is different, sterilization is different. Sterilization is a process in which the total and complete destruction of all types of bacteria are takes place, but in disinfection only the pathogenic bacteria are killed. Okay, and then we are making that water safe. Safe water means what? Water which is free from bacteria, water which is aesthetically acceptable, water free from excessive minerals and poisonous matter. Okay, so the process of killing pathogenic bacteria from the water and that make that water safe, that process is called as disinfection. See, what are the main objectives of the disinfection? See, the main objective of the disinfection is to kill the pathogenic bacteria present in the water after the filtration process, and second one is the main objective is to prevent the contamination of water during its transits from the treatment plant to the place of its consumption. These are the two main objectives of the disinfection. Now second point is the types of disinfectant. See, what do you mean by a disinfectant? The chemicals or substances which are to be used for the disinfection, that is called as disinfectant. Okay, see, the concentration and potency of the disinfectant that affect the efficiency of the disinfection. There are various types of disinfectants are there which are to be used for the disinfection of the water, like sodium hypochlorite, chlorine dioxide, peracetic acid, quaternary ammonium compound. These are the some examples of the disinfectant which we have to be utilized for the disinfection purpose. Now next point is the mechanism of the disinfection. How this disinfection processes takes place? See, there are four actions are takes place whenever we are adding the disinfectant into the water. These four actions are takes place. First one, whenever we are adding the disinfectant into the water, it damages to the cell wall of the microorganism or the pathogen, and alteration of cell permeability. They alter the cell permeability and make them harmless. The changing the colloidal nature of the cell protoplasm. The change, that disinfectant change the colloidal nature of that bacteria's cell protoplasm and make them harmless, and the inactivation of the critical enzyme system which is responsible for the metabolic activity, and by that way they will reduce and kill the pathogen and make that water harmless. In this way that disinfection process takes place. Now see, methods of the disinfection, there are various methods are used for the disinfection of the water. Like first one is the boiling of water, second one is the treatment with excess lime, third one is the use of ozone, fourth one is the treatment with ultraviolet rays, fifth one is the Use of potassium permanganate. Sixth one is the treatment with silver. And lastly, use of bromine, iodine and chlorine. These are the various methods we are used for the disinfection purpose. Now later we have discussed all that method one by one in detail. See, methods of disinfection. First one is the boiling of water. See, this boiling of water method is most effective method of the disinfection of the water. What we are doing in this method? We just boil the water. So whenever the boiling point is more than 100 degrees Celsius, what are the pathogens which are to be present in the water that are get killed? Okay? But this boiling of water method cannot be used for huge quantities of the public water supply. And this boiling of water cannot take care of the future possible contamination of that water. Therefore, whenever we are supplying the water to the public through the transit system, if that water is get polluted, we can't take care of that. So this method is not used in water treatment plant for the disinfection purpose. Now next method is the treatment with excess lime. See, this treatment with excess lime method, where this effectively kill the bacteria, but this cannot be safeguard the future pollution of the water. See, in this case, the enough lime is added to the water to increase its pH value to 9.5 or more, and thereby the most of the bacteria will be killed. See, due to the increasing pH value, there is recarbonation is necessary. The process of removal of excess lime before it is supplied to the public, that process is known as the recarbonation. Okay, and because for the drinking purpose, the pH should be in between 6.5 to 8. So we have to remove this excess lime from the water and to reduce the pH range up to 6.5 to 8. So make that water potable. So for a recarbonation purpose, we are adding the carbon dioxide into it. Now next method is the ozone treatment. See, ozone is more powerful disinfectant than the chlorine. Ozone is more costly also than the chlorine. But the drawback is that ozone is cannot be stored. This used for the disinfection of water on a small scale, such as for the swimming pool of that water. Okay. So in this way, that ozone is used as a disinfectant. Next one is the iodine and bromine. See, iodine and bromine used in water supply for army troops, private plant and swimming pool. This cannot be used for the public water supply because this iodine and bromine are costly. Next one is the ultraviolet ray. See, this ultraviolet ray treatment is very costly technique, and this is an effective method for the disinfection of the water. But the drawback is that no residual effect is available for the protection against the future contamination. That's why this method is also not used in the water treatment plant for the disinfection of the water. Next one is the potassium permanganate. See, for the disinfecting the well water supplies, which are generally contaminated with lesser amount of bacteria, in that case, potassium permanganate is used for the disinfection purpose. But the drawback is, the advantage is that that potassium permanganate can remove the 100% of organism causing that cholera. See, this potassium permanganate mostly used in the rural water supply scheme, where the source of water is the well water. Okay, so in that case, water is transmitted from well up to the ESR, that is elevated service reservoir, and that we are adding the potassium permanganate into the water, and then we have to disinfect that, and then we have to supply that water to the people. Next method is the silver or electrocatadine process. This silver and electrocatadine process remove algae and take care of the future pollution, but the drawback is that these methods are very costly. And last method is the chlorination method. See, this chlorination method, in which we are adding the chlorine into the water for the disinfection purpose. See, this method, chlorination method, is universally adopted for the public water supply because it is capable of providing residual disinfecting effects. That is very important effect for longer period. And it take care of any possible future contamination of that water. and the addition of chloride does not produce any significant change in the pH value. That's why mostly in practical, in water treatment plant, chlorine is used as a disinfectant. Now, next are the factors affecting disinfection. There are various factors which are affecting the disinfection process, like type, condition and concentration of organisms to be destroyed. Okay, so see, the concentration and nature of the organism which are to be present in the water, that will also affect the efficiency of the disinfection process. If the large concentration or large concentration of bacteria are there, longer the time is required for the disinfection purpose. So the type, condition and concentration of organism also affect the disinfection process or efficiency. Then the type and concentration of disinfectant. The nature of disinfectant and the concentration of disinfectant which we have to be utilized for the disinfection purpose, that will also affect the disinfection efficiency. Third one is the contact time and concentration of disinfectant in water. Contact time. See, how much contact time will be there? The effect of temperature on the, the contact time. See, it has been observed that for a given concentration of disinfectant, longer the contact time, greater will be the disinfection efficiency. So, the contact time and the concentration of disinfection, that will also affect the efficiency of the disinfection process. Then the physical, chemical, physical characteristics of the water to be treated, that will also affect the disinfection process, because the nature of suspended liquid is an important factor and must be evaluated carefully. The substances like ammonia, iron, manganese and organic matter, they interfere the disinfection process, and the organic matter will react with the most oxidizing disinfectant, and that will reduce the effectiveness of the disinfection. See, turbidity also reduce the effectiveness of disinfectant by absorbing and by protecting the intact bacteria. That's why this physical and chemical characteristic also affect the efficiency of the disinfection. And lastly, temperature, pH and mineral constituent which are present in the water, that will also cause the disinfection. Temperature. See, the effect of temperature on rate of killing the bacteria, that will also very, very important. Because as the temperature increases, the bacteria decreases or killed. pH value, that will also be very important, because the effectiveness of the chlorine get reduced, because we are using the chlorine as a disinfectant, and the effectiveness of chlorine get reduced with the increasing pH values. Okay. The strong and effective hypochlorous acid is formed when the is greater, when the quantities of pH is low, and at high pH value, that less hypochlorous acid is formed. That's why this temperature, pH value and mineral constituent affect the disinfection efficiency. So I hope that student, all of you understand this disinfection concept very well. If you have any difficulty or any question, you can ask me frankly. Thank you.